What's up, everybody? Welcome back to Green Shorts Gaming. My name is AJ, and we're playing Tomba 2. And last time we were in the town of the fishermen, now we're gonna continue on in the underground pipe area of the coal mining town, where it's gonna get nice and steamy. And here's Tomba. And from last time, remember I told you about the cappers, we gotta get rid of them. They're kind of clogging up the pipes in this area. None of the machines are working, so we gotta save the town in our own little way. But first, let's talk to this guy. Notice his accent.
What am I going to do? I can't get back to town now.
You stuck, bruh?
The town?
You stuck?
Are you referring to the coal mining town?
Yes, I am. How do you know of it?
A friend of ours lives there.
Anyway, this guy's from the coal mining town, he's gonna tell us about the ice boomerang that we're gonna need.
Oh, where's an ice boomerang?
There we go. To clear the cappers. It kind of quenches the fire, and then that helps us actually bite them and throw them out of the way. Because without the ice boomerang, we're gonna just end up hurting ourselves jumping on top of, you know, fire. Alright. So we talked to that guy. Notice his accent. It's right now it's American, and later on, it changes to a different accent for some reason after you get the ice boomerang. Alright. Remember, in the starting beach when I told you guys, always have some water in your bucket. Because this is why.
Water.
Water. This guy be thirsty. The thirst is building. I wonder how long he's been sitting here without water. Here, bruh, have some water. Man, that's a square bucket. Achievement! Ooh, yeah.
Thank you. You saved me.
Kind of sounds
like. I've got to pay you back somehow.
What's his name? That dude from Jurassic Park. I forgot his name.
I've got it. I'll give you some information. It's supposed to be a secret, of course.
Oh, okay.
Have you ever heard of the Tower of Courage? Well, there was something about a legendary tower. In fact, I.
And he tells us about the Tower of Courage, which is one of those things that. They're like secret areas. You don't need it to finish the game, but they're secret areas scattered. There's the Tower of Courage, the Tower of Wisdom, Tower of Strength, I think. They give you extra weapons and stuff. Or like upgrades to your existing weapons. And you need to unlock the songs by completing tasks with people, and we're gonna try our best to get to those towers. But all he gave us was information. Well, I guess the water was easy enough to get. Like this thing right here, which is the power coal we're gonna use in the next area, the actual coal mining town. So, we're gonna go down here. Down here. I'm gonna get that ice boomerang. Whoop. I thought I could hit that piggy. Alright, let's go over here. Boom. Got a nice boomerang. What we're gonna do first is get rid of this guy. Oh, he's back. All right, we're gonna get rid of this guy. Thusly, cram it down its throat and steal its innards. We're gonna go here. Whoops. And get this mudball surprise. This very mysterious black mudball. There's gonna be two of them in this level. And we're gonna need them for later for the trolley stop. These guys, they look like ghosts from Pac-Man. When they turn blue and stuff. Like this guy, he's all pissed. He's like, I'm gonna get you. No, you're not. No, you ain't. Alright. So the chains are on fire. We gotta put them out first, and then, oh, he thought I was gonna die. I thought I was gonna die. I was like, no. Alright. There's more cappers down here, and this is the area that leads to the trolley station. Oh man, I was hoping to get a combo with that. Let's try this. Boom. Ah, it missed. Just missed. Oh yeah. Alright. So everything down here is cleared. We just gotta yank this chain over here that opens the gate to the next area. First quenched it. Pull it down. Cause you know, that guy, he can't pull it by himself. He needs Tomba to do it for some reason. He's just standing there. It's like, I can't get into the town. Unless he locked it himself. He was the guy who put the chains up. So nobody can get in. Conspiracies. God damn it. Can't do combos now. Let's try this guy. Boom! There you go. 200 points. I guess you can just farm points by restarting levels and get 200s all the time. Just hitting other pigs with other pigs. Other enemies. Anyway, we're not gonna go up there yet. Because we don't need to. But we are gonna grab this mud ball surprise. Now we got two mud ball surprises. But that's not all. We need one more mud ball. Just a regular one, you know. Not a surprise. Just a regular mud ball. Boom. And you'll see why in the next area. Trying to get as much as we can, and I think I got all the cappers on this side, so we're gonna get this chick food. Gonna get rid of, I think, one more capper after this guy, the one in the beginning of the level. But first, let's piss this guy off. Oh, what's up? I missed it. I don't want to hit him, like, I don't want to touch him, I mean. Come on. Oh, good. Hello. Aha, there we go. And then we're gonna get this other dude. Get his innards. That was apparently an anemone. A mutant anemone. You know, like those things that Nemo and his dad lives in. Some reason. Boom, we got him. There are anemones down here. And let's talk to this guy again. Listen to his accent. Remember his accent earlier, where it was like American and he was just talking? Listen to this guy.
Have you used the animal dash? It's fast, speed, and jump systems are mighty
convenient.
All
of a sudden, he changes accent.
You move by holding square.
Square.
Also, you can use a weapon to extend distance and power. I've seen it work against enemies.
I don't know if this guy was a different guy or he's just, you know, he does impressions or something. It sounds like a mix between Indian and German. But I thought it was just funny how he changes accents all the time. I didn't notice it when I first played the game when I was like 7, but as I continued playing the game over the years, I was like, wait a minute, that's not the same voice. Anyway, let's go over here to Gran, open the gate for him, because we cleared all the cappers and all the stuff that's blocking the town. Oh, a little bit of lag. Ooh.
Well, thanks to you, we can go home now. We don't have much to offer, but please feel free to stay as long as you wish.
He's one of my other favorite characters.
Long time no see.
Why, hello there, Zippo. How are ya?
He's just really friendly.
I'm doing fine.
Friendly guy.
The machines in the town are finally running.
Yeah, thanks to us.
The door should be open now.
Tomba, quick! Let's go to Tabby's!
Oh yeah, Tabby. We forgot about Tabby. Yeah, we're supposed to go there.
Come to think of it, I should get back into town too.
You think, bruh? You think? Alright, let's check out this sweet loading screen again. It's like we're actually traveling into town. Just imagine, like, having the PS1 in 1999 and then having that loading screen. It's like, oh my god, it's like... Yeah, so you, like, everybody's used to, like, loading screens that says loading, black screens, and you're like, you play this game, and you're like, woo. So, now we're in Coal Mining Town. Let's explore a little bit and meet the locals. Apparently, these guys are miners, and they coal, they gather coal from the mountain. So, let's talk to this guy. One of my favorite scenes with it, in this game, by the way.
What do you think? Is this a great pot or what?
A pot?
Master Potter here in town made it for me a long time ago.
Hmm.
Ooh, look at that gloss and that form. It's wonderful.
He loves his pot.
I've got to get to work.
What, he just sits here in his house all day staring at his pot instead of working?
Don't touch that.
Sure. So, I'm controlling Tomba now, and we could do as he says and just kind of mosey our way out of here, but I kind of feel like touching it. Let's see what happens. Oh, well, that was kind of scary. It almost fell. Alright, I'm not going to do it again. Nah, what the heck. Let's do it!
I don't like this, Tomba.
Me neither.
Can't imagine. What's that sound? Oh!
And just...
Oh no! My precious pot! I like it so much!
And just so you know, there's no way of not breaking that pot. You have to break that to get these events. It's an optional event, but it's really helpful. Especially to getting those towers.
You did it on purpose.
No, I did not.
It's alright. Things always break eventually.
Aw, man, he's crying now.
It's okay. It's not asking too much. Could you help pick up the pieces? I can't stand to look.
Sure, it's the least we could do.
Might better leave it alone.
Okay. So, one of my favorite lines in this game. This...
Oh, my pot!
And he just keeps saying that. And I kind of feel sorry now because, you know, we broke his pot. But we have to. And it'll work itself out. Later on. I'm not gonna go in here yet. We're gonna fix the pot in this little apartment complex later on. But first, we gotta talk to this lady. Just to activate this event.
Hey, travelers.
Oh, what happened to you? Man, that place is a dangerous work area.
I can heal wounds fast. He went to look for it, and...
He went on an epic quest.
If you meet my son somewhere, will you tell him to come on home?
Sure, no problem. No problem.
I'm worried about him.
I'll just roam around the land randomly and be like... just talk to every kid I see and be like... Hey, there's a lady in Coal Mining Town. If she's your mom, she's looking for you. And let's go in here and activate these quests real quick. Yeah, steak sandwiches for oily smears, potato sandwiches for laughing and crying, which will be a status change later in the Donglin Forest, and the dried fish for invisibility, also in the Donglin Forest. I like that name, Donglin. Anyway, let's talk to Chef. Really groovy guy.
What are you doing here? This isn't a playground, you know.
Good day, Mr. Chef.
He's Mr. Chef.
Is that you, Zippo? If you're hungry, why don't you have some health dishes prepared from my secret recipe? I wish I could make it for you. Unfortunately, the stove is on the fritz and it won't light. Do you have a recipe book there? If you bring me the ingredients, maybe I can fix something.
Yeah, see what I mean by groovy? This was 1999, and it was like, yeah, man, what's up? So we gotta grab all the ingredients, the fish, the meat, and the potatoes, so he can make sandwiches for us. And first, before we go to Tabby's house, which is like the main point of this game, we're gonna stall a little bit more and just, you know, gather sand, you know, because we can. We gotta fill this hole, because we're gonna have to later on anyway. You can do this before or after you go to Tabby's house. So, let's just do it before, you know. I think this is a quicker way to do it. Because you don't have to go take two trips to Tabby's house later on. And this part right here, for people who speedrun the game, it's a really difficult part, because as the camera switches around, you have to adjust with your motion. So right now, if I just hold the right button, I go in a circle. So you gotta hold up, right, stuff like that. And it's kind of tricky, and people who speedrun the game are not too thrilled about this part. Alright, so let's go to the red door, Tabby's house. Do-do-do-do.
Just as I suspected, she isn't here.
She gone.
Wait a minute, Tomba. You hear that noise?
Oh, maybe she's in the closet.
What the?
It's a big pile of poop.
Hey, what's all this ruckus? Wow.
The hell is that?
What is that?
You took the words right out of my mouth.
Yeah. Crazy.
One huge dirt ball.
Crazy world we live in.
Why don't we use the washing machine in the underground machine room to figure out what it is?
All right then, let's do it. Let's clean this up. It's like Tabby in there.
I'll carry it for you, Tomba. I don't want you to hurt yourself.
So if you didn't do the hole covering with the sand that we did earlier, you're gonna, this part right here cuts off, and he tells you to fill that hole. But we already did that, so he's just gonna carry it for us, like so.
I wonder what's under all that gunk. Let's go to the underground machine room.
Let's go. Let us go. Oh, but first let's just, you know, steal Tabby's treasures, you know, because we can. We got a red key. We might as well use it. And you have to stand right in front of it so you can press circle. And look at that. We got a lunchbox from a treasure chest. Somebody's hoarding food. Is that why she left? She went to rehab for hoarding? Alright, this is the heart of Coal Mining Town.
Whoa. Who would have thought that something like this would be underground?
Yep.
Go figure.
Yep, that's how everything works.
Pretty
in this
cool,
town.
Huh? Well, let's find out what this thing is.
And this is their washing machine. That's where they clean all their clothes.
Small world. Oh, I forgot something important.
And it's Charles.
Excuse me. I just remembered
he's Tomba's, I guess. I don't know if he's Tomba's best friend, but he keeps getting into trouble. And we gotta save him all the time.
Charles, what were you doing?
He's a little slow in the head, too.
Zippo? Tomba? What are you guys doing?
We should be asking you. All I know is we found you bundled up in a lump of dirt.
Yeah, what the hell happened to you, dude?
Oh, yeah. I fell into some mud, so I was looking for somewhere to get it off.
Really?
But by the time I got here, the mud dried and I got stuck.
And that's how you became that lump? Alrighty then.
He's just like, alrighty then. Alright.
Crying out loud, I can't find that thing anywhere.
What seems to be the problem?
And this is Mole. He lost his hammer, and we're gonna take it from him.
I can't find my hammer.
Oh.
You don't know what a hammer is? You know, a hammer.
A hammer.
Oh, a hammer.
Yeah, a hammer, dude. Yeah. So we gotta find his hammer. He left it at the trolley stop.
Charles! Charles!
And Charles just leaves us for some reason. He's like, I gotta find that hammer. There's something about people in this game and losing stuff, like, randomly. Like, and it's up to Tomba to find it, I guess. I don't know. Let's see. Do we have... Okay. We got the power coal. We're gonna do that first, and then... Oop, we're going into Gran's house and gonna steal his treasures, too. Because we can. And we shall. This is an actual treasure. Look at that. A gem worth 1,000 points. Ooh yeah. Let's go over here and hand the coal to this guy, because apparently their coal in this town sucks. See that thing he's shoveling into the conveyor belt? Apparently it's not enough to power the whole area, so we're gonna give him something good.
In fact, this underground machinery works because I wanted a way to transport fuel. Hey, what's this? You got some good stuff. Let me have some of it.
I got the stuff. You got the money? Give me the money. Give me the AP, the points. Look at that. It's like a lava rock. A lava rock. All right, then. Look at that. Ooh, shaky. Rumble feature. Immersive.
All right. This should give me enough heat.
I don't know about you guys, but I leave, whenever I play games, I leave the rumble on. I know it takes, kind of distracts people, especially those playing competitively for FPSs and stuff. And it drains the battery more, but I like leaving it on because, yeah, it makes the game more immersive. And one more thing before we find the hammer, we're going to clean the mud balls that we got from the lava area with the washing machine. Because apparently there's some good stuff in here too. You can wash anything in here. You can wash clothes. You can wash this iron ore or metal ore or whatever. You can wash hammers, weapons. You can wash your car in there probably if this game had cars. I know the first Tomba had a buggy section. That was fun. Yeah. So there might be cars in this universe, in the Tomba universe. Wash, 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 wash. And these are going to be important later on, especially when we have the hammer. They're useful for creating a light alloy, a new type of metal that'll help the trolley minecart go faster. And this is clay. We need it for that pot we just broke at the beginning of the area, if you guys remember. So let's go give that guy his pot back. Since, you know, we accidentally broke it. But first we gotta make it. So that's what this place is for. Oh, it's the tool shed. Alright, so these guys, they have their beds in here. They live here, so they're tools. This is their shed. So what's up, Tool? What's up?
I just can't understand the creative urge. Oh, I guess I can't do it without that clay spatula.
Oh, you mean,
Where did I...
You mean, see, this thing?
What? I remember.
I didn't time that right, but I was going to say, you mean this thing? Now you see what I mean about people in this game and losing stuff. It's up to Tomba to find all the... I'm like
fantastic.
A walking lost and found here.
Oh. Actually, I don't have any of the precious clay.
Oh, that's too bad.
Mistake.
Oh, wait, you mean this thing? I did it.
Wow, it's here. C-L-A-Y.
I think the voice actor for this guy is famous. Don't quote me on that, but I think he is. If not, then never mind. Look at the master at work. That's how you make pots, guys.
It's ready. I did it so fast, I even surprised myself. Thank you. You helped me to create my first work of art in a long time.
No problem, man. I appreciate it. This is a pot that I would stare at all day and miss work for.
Yeah, I heard all about you removing the cappers, but I have something for you to do. My job is to get on the trolley at the Pops area trolley stop to hoist cement.
Hoist cement.
But it takes technique, speed, and I never get it right.
Man, so, that's what happened to your arm,
like
huh?
I would like to ride the trolley in my place.
Sure.
You can figure.
So, he gives us his license, his ticket, I guess. And now we get to do his job for him, because apparently he sucks and he hurts himself when he does his job.
Seeds of strength. See if you can grab some.
But then again, working down there, as you'll see later on, isn't too safe. So, let's go over here and give this guy his pot back. Hey, bruh. You sad? You sad? You mad? I got you some pot. I mean, I got you your new pot. Here you go.
Oh, my pot.
Pot?
It is truly a master artisan's pot. I thought I had the last one made.
Nah, man.
You're giving me this? You were worried about me? Thank you.
Of course
so much.
We were. Of course. You are welcome. This is half of a song we need to summon the Tower of Courage. That thing that Traveler was talking about.
A long time ago. Sounds sort of like an incantation. Still,
incantation?
To me it has kind of a half-baked feel.
Ha! Half-baked. Notice how his walls are the only green walls in this town, too.
But it ought to help you guys on your trip.
Ooh, thank you. We learned half a spell. Thanks for giving us half of something when we gave you... Well, we technically broke his thing, so... Look, he has green braces on his house. The tool shed has... red? Or yellow? Blue. Okay, blue braces. This has red braces. But anyway, let's go grab that hammer now since we got everything in this town. Well, almost everything. For now. And let's go ahead and find that hammer that Mole lost. Mole's just too lazy. He can just go back in the trolley stop and, you know, look over there. And instead, he's moping around in the machine room, doing nothing. And he's making us go over there for him. But then again, we get to keep the hammer, so... I guess we win. In a way. There it is. We found it. We got an achievement too. Oh yeah.
There you are. Where did the two of you run off to?
We were looking
what
for the hammer.
What are you talking about? You're the one who went running off. What's the matter anyways?
Yeah, and it was you who left.
The foreman is looking for you.
The foreman?
You mean Grant?
Right. He said he saw Tabby.
Oh yeah, Tabby.
Tomba, hurry.
We keep forgetting
Let's
about Tabby.
So we can find Grant.
And epic music's coming up real soon.
We found your hammer, Mole.
Forget the hammer. This is more important.
Really?
What's the matter, Mole?
Bran is trapped in the pipe area.
Trapped
by a huge boulder. And that place is unstable. If it collapses, you'll fall in a pool of hot water.
Uh-oh.
Why can't we just use the hammer to break it?
No, it's too big. We need something stronger. Bran mentioned something about getting the bomb.
That's what she said.
Don't worry, we'll find some.
Thank you. Please hurry. To activate the bomb.
Yes, we will need the hammer. So, he gives us his hammer, which is good. Since, you know, we need it. We need it for a lot of things in this game. And it's just a satisfying weapon to use. So now, look, we got the hammer. It's at the bottom of the screen. And we can do this and activate stuff with it. And it can also hit enemies, except for the cappers, because the cappers, the only thing that can that kind of touch the cappers is the ice boomerang, because you gotta freeze them first before you do anything. Well, here we go. Boom. That's how doors open in this area. It was sealed for a reason. So those are the bombs. First time I played this game, I got stuck in this part because I didn't know you're supposed to hit the stuff with the hammers. Those switches, you're supposed to hit them with a hammer, and I was like stuck for the longest time until I finally discovered Google for the first time. I used Google to search how to finish this game, and that's how I learned about Google. And I didn't have a computer of my own, so I had to go to a net cafe or whatever, you know, those places where you pay per hour to use their computers and use the internet. And that's how I found out how to finish the game, finally. So now, you know, I have an Android phone, I got Chrome browser installed, and everything else is Google. Google's gonna rule the world soon.
Bad idea. We're really gonna need those bombs.
Man, that's a dumb idea. Even though you're like ripping stuff, you don't punch boulders. Don't do that. Just don't. You need bombs.
Hit the switch with the hammer!
Alright, let's do it. But first, alright. We gotta use momentum here. Alright, let's charge up our attack. And then boom. Oh, okay. I was like, nothing's happening. Takes a while for the fuse. It's a slow fuse. But the rumble effect for this section is pretty good, too.
Are you okay, Grant?
What's up, brah?
Woo! That was close. I thought it was over for me.
Anytime. You happen to see Tabby around lately?
Yes, I did. As a matter of fact, I saw her headed for the Kajara Ranch.
Oh, that's where she went.
The Kajara Ranch?
That's right. It's only a trolley ride away, but I tried to stop her because of the evil pig spell.
That's going to be in the next area.
Hopefully, she isn't in any
a
danger.
A snowy area.
What am I saying? She'll be fine.
I hope so.
The mountain itself is dangerous. But if you ride the trolley, it's fairly safe.
Fairly. Emphasis on fairly.
I forgot to fix the rails.
You forgot. Again. He's the foreman, and he keeps forgetting to fix stuff. And he just dropped that.
Uh-oh, Tomba. Gran dropped the rails for the trolley track. Let's meet him there.
This is how people lose stuff in this game. Like that huge hammer. Those rails, people just walk nonchalantly and drop stuff. They don't care if they hear like a huge clank behind them. They don't care. They'll just find someone named Tomba and be like, I lost something really important, go find it for me. these people. Alright. That's why you need water, by the way. Always have some water. This is the only place in the game where you can get some hot water, and that's gonna be helpful later on in the ice area, as you will see. So I think we got everything down here. We don't need to go back unless we do the trolley side mission. It's like a little mini game where you control a minecart. But I think I'm going to do a separate video on that, do a little montage, because it might take me multiple tries. And you know, I haven't played this in a while, so I might suck at it, and it's going to take longer than it should. So we got the hammer now. Before we do anything else, I want to cook some of the meat that we just got from Chef's cafeteria with this oven right here. Yes, it's an oven that can cook. It's multi-purpose, so you can cook this Vitamite, these metals, you can cook them, or you can cook some meat. Make some steak. And if you didn't give that guy upstairs the power coal, once you use this without the power coal running, you'll only have like a rare steak, and you have to cook it multiple times to get this big steak that we just got, because the fire isn't as hot as it should be. But if you did what I did and gave him the power coal beforehand, you should be good. Let's cook this piece of meat, and then we'll cook the banana and the two, let's purify those metals real quick. And this is the only place you can get it. You need the hammer before you do all of this. So yeah, there's no avoiding backtracking to this area. So we don't backtrack anymore. I'm just gonna cook as much as we can and combine the two metals to make the light alloy for later on. Baked banana is going to be for guess who? Yep, the monkey. We're going to give it to him later on because he's going to get into more trouble. But right now, let's open the oven first. I was wondering why the option wouldn't let me cook stuff. But here we go. We're technically purifying it, not cooking it, so, you know, we're smelting it like we do in Minecraft. We get some pure stuff from the ores. Pure Lightamite, because it's got to be light and hard. Do that as you wish. And we're gonna cook this one too. And I don't, if you don't have the power coal, I don't think it smokes. Like, I don't think there's that black smoke that comes out. I don't think so. But this is the combining chamber where you can combine anything you want. And it stays open until you choose another item to combine with. I wish you could combine weapons, you know, in this game, since there's a machine that can do that. We got a light alloy. Somebody should take it from us. Yep.
Huh? How did you make that light alloy?
I'm a genius.
Hey, if it's all right with you,
what you talking about?
Give that light alloy to me.
What's in it for me?
I'd like to fix the underground trolley. The one we have is rickety. Doesn't move very fast anymore.
Yeah, we're nice guys, so we're gonna just give it to him.
I'd like to take it down to the trolley stop. Make a really fast trolley.
Alright then, let's go. Alright. So, we cooked the meat, and I'm gonna show you guys something cool. So, this game has fast travel by ways of multiple things. But we're going to use the magic wings for the first time to go to the starting beach and make us some dried fish. if you guys remember that net at the beginning, that's where we put all the fish we caught. And we're gonna make some dried fish. I'm thinking about dried fish now. It's making me hungry. I'm Asian and, you know, we have dried fish in our culture. It's a thing. I prefer dried squid, but dried fish is good too. What we do is we just fry it straight on a pan with some oil. But some cultures, they like to put it in soup. Some like to turn it into flakes, like the Japanese do. Then they use it as seasoning. Because once you dry the fish, it turns salty. If you've never had it, it has like a certain smell to it too. Like, because basically you cut the fish open, you clean it, and you let it rot in the sun for several days, and it turns salty and it tastes good. And some people like to turn it into flakes and use it as like the salt seasoning for their food. It's really good. Like I said, I personally prefer dried squid because that stuff's the bomb. That's just, oh my god. Just fry it or grill it and then dip it in some vinegar. Some vinegar with salt and peppers and a little bit of garlic and some chili peppers. Yeah, that's the way to eat it. Whoa! Alright, so we got everything in this area. We're gonna go back to the coal mining town with one of our magic wings. And actually, we're gonna get a sandwich and we're gonna talk to Gran and go on to the next area. So where is that? Oh, okay, I got confused for a bit. Here we go. And we're back. I don't know what other games during this era, 1999, like for the PlayStation that had fast travel. It seems like this game was way ahead of its time in terms of mechanics and stuff. So we're gonna give the chef our big steak.
Oh, I have some recipe ingredients. Let me show you what I can do.
Do 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 do.
Go on, bring me something good.
That's my favorite line by him. Go on, bring me something good. And we're just...
If you find any other ingredients, bring them too.
I shall. You got it. We're just gonna give him the other steak too to cook for us, since we're already here.
Oh, I have some...
And we're just going to skip because you guys already heard what he says. And he says the same thing all the time, even if you give him the dried fish or the potatoes or the steak. Does not matter.
Go on.
Bring me something new.
If you find.
Yes, sir. All right. So we're leaving. We don't need those pieces of meat that are glowing over there because we already got what we need. We're going to talk to Gran. Give him this. He looks all depressed and stuff. He's like, I lost something. I'm so stupid. There you go. There you go.
There it is. I was looking all over for it. Now I can finally do the repairs.
Even when he's sad, he's smiling. That's just the texture pasted on his face.
All fixed up. Cabin, listen to that. Right on time.
They're right on time. You said they were right on time.
What's wrong?
Tabby isn't here. This doesn't look too good.
She gone.
Help, help!
Emphasis on fairly safe.
Control yourself. Tell me what happened.
The pigs to Tabby. They tried to steal her pendant. She wouldn't give it up.
She fought them for a stupid necklace?
No, it's not stupid.
That stupid necklace was a gift from Tomba long ago.
Yeah. kind of looks like a little hat.
Who are you? Where's Tabby?
Tabby's just fine. In fact, you'd do better to just forget about her.
Oh, hell no. That's the evil pig. We gotta kill him. We gotta stuff him in a bag so he suffocates to death.
I haven't the slightest idea. It took that.
That's essentially what you do in the first game and in this game too. You stuff the pigs in their pig bags and who knows where they're going. It's like Pokemon. You stuff them in Pokeballs.
That's right. They appeared a little while ago on this continent and they've cursed the entire land.
And I know that there's Pokeballs technically teleport them somewhere.
I have something that can break it.
But, you know, I like to think of Pokeballs as like a prison.
Legend has it, where a spell is cast, you can find a pig bag.
Legend? It's a fact. You're holding one right now.
And if you have a pig bag, it reveals their hiding place.
Alright then. Give us a bag and we can go find Tabby.
I understand.
Alright.
Well, at least take this to help you on your journeys.
We shall. Thanks, Gren. It was nice meeting you. But now we gotta split. Gonna ride this minecart out of here. Too hot. We need some air conditioning. And it has rails too. So because we're on a minecart, so that's cool. Look at that. So cold. So nice and calm. All right. So this is the next area. So. Oh, what's this? Oh my god! 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 It's so shiny. Let's get it. Uh-oh. There we go. Took me a while, but I got it. So, that's gonna be it for this episode of Green Shorts Gaming. And we froze. Yeah, if you stand too long in the snow, you'll freeze. Look at him shivering. But that's gonna be it for this episode. Next time we're gonna meet Santa Claus. We're gonna find Tabby, hopefully. Gonna gather more snow fireflies and maybe talk to this lady over here and find out a way to not freeze. Wow, we're getting a lot of these snow fireflies and we're gonna need those. So thanks for watching. If you like the video, like or subscribe and comment down below, you know, tell me stuff I need to know. You know, you don't have to, but you could. It's your choice. Anyway, see you guys.